Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can create and use global pick list value set in Salesforce Lightning. Before starting, let me share you how you can search me on YouTube. You can type my name. My channel will be available there. You can watch various Salesforce related videos here. So to create global pick list value set, we need to search pick list in setup, and this option pick list value sets will be available there. Here it will show all existing global value sets, and you can also create new one. So let me first open this existing global value set. Its name is country, and it is having these values already available. So if you are creating a pick list field on different objects, and those fields are having same values, so instead of typing those values again and again, you can create a global pick list value set, and you can use that in those objects while creating pick list. So this way I created country pick list, which is having several values. If you want to add new value in this pick list value set, you can type it here, and then like I want to add Japan, and it is saying add the new pick list values to all record types that use this global value set. So if multiple record types are using this global value set, and if you want to add this, then you can check it as true, otherwise leave it as it is. So I'm clicking on save. So this way you can see values added. If you want to reorder these values, you can click on reorder, and you can change the order of these values. You can also change the default value. If you want to display values alphabetically, you can check this checkbox. Then if you want to replace a pick list value with new, so for this you need to understand this. So globally replace an existing value in a pick list with a new value. Make sure you have created the new value on the pick list field first. Note that replacing an existing pick list value will update the records last modified by date and time. So these things you need to consider while replacing existing pick list value. So the existing pick list value we need to enter here, and new value we need to select from here. So on the records where existing value will be available, it will be replaced automatically with the new value. And if you want to replace all blank values with a particular value, then you can do this. So if record is having blank in a particular pick list value where we are using this global value set, so a new value will be replaced with China. So this way you can do this. Then here you have options of edit, delete, and deactivate. If you want to change the value, you can click on edit. If you want to delete, you can click on delete. But if this pick list value is used in any record, then you will not be able to delete it. Then you can do it deactivate. So when you click on deactivate, so this value will be coming under this section, and it will be available also on the record. But while you are creating new records, then that deactivated value will not be available. And if you want to active that value again, you can click on activate. So then it will be available for new records as well. Then here you can see fields where this pick list value or global pick list value set is used. So on a student object, while creating two pick lists, this global value set is used. So this way you can identify where it is used. Now, if you want to create new global pick list value set, you can click on new and fill these details: label, name, then values separated by new line, then these two checkboxes, which are simple for alphabetical order and default value. So this way you can create. Now I'm going to use this country global pick list value set for creating new pick list field on book object. So I'm going to create two pick list. One is simple pick list and one is pick list multi-select. And while creating both, I'm going to use same country global value set. So first I am creating pick list. So we are going to select the author's country. So here you can see this option is by default selected, and here global value set is available. So I chose that. Now you can see these options are not available to select because these are controlled by the global value set. Then you can fill description, help text, required and default values. So I already explained these things in my previous video, which was related to how to create pick list and multi-pick list. Then here you can see field level security. So I'm selecting visible for all the profiles. Then it should be added on book layout so that we can see it. I'm clicking on save and new so that I can create one more field, that is pick list multi-select. So now label is available where, or we can say available in which country. Then again, this is default. So I'm selecting country. Number of visible lines are 4. Here also you can see these checkboxes are faded because these are controlled by the global value set. Then we have description, help text, required and default value options. So you can use them as per your requirement. Then visible for all the profiles, and it should be available on book layout. Now I'm going to open my university app where our book tab is placed. So I'm opening existing record first. So here you can see author's country and available in which country, both are available. So I'm converting it into edit mode. So here you can see all the options are available. We can choose a particular country name, then available in which country. So we can choose multiple countries and click on save. So this way you can see we used single pick list value set into multiple pick list fields. So we didn't type these country names again and again. We commonly created a global value set and used them while creating pick list on objects. And if you create new record, then also these values will be available. So here you can see default value is Australia. Here also default is this because our global value set says default will be this. And if I remove that, so clicking on reorder, making default as none. Refreshing it. This time Yeah, here you can see default is none and here chosen is no, has no values. So if we change something in this, so you need to refresh it, and after refreshing that change will impact here. So I removed default as Australia. Now default is none. So default as none will be for all these pick list which are on student or book objects. So I hope you understood how we can create and use global pick list values so that we can reduce our efforts and we can apply common settings for all the pick list with the help of global pick list value set. I hope you understood whatever I demonstrated in this video. If you want to watch more Salesforce related videos, search me on YouTube by my name. Thank you for watching this video.